Good morning, everyone, once again. So now let us start with the class because it's already 10:30 and I had given a time for everybody to join exactly at 10:30. Okay, so shall we start the class? Can we go ahead, children? Okay. So in the last class, we have studied about the simple machines. So now in today's class, we'll study about mechanical advantage. Okay. So on your screen, you can see this. What you can see here? Here you can see this man is using a car jack to lift up the car. So in this case, car jack is also a simple machine. Yes, but why this car jack is a simple machine? Because by applying a smaller force or a small effort, we can lift up heavier object. Yes, this man is using this car jack and you can see that he is lifting this heavy car. Correct. So can you tell me this car jack? It's a simple machine, we know that. But can you tell me where will be the effort given and which is the load in this case, children? Can you tell me where this man is giving the effort and which one is the effort load in this case? Can you tell me? Because what is load and what is effort, you have understood in the previous class. So now tell me where the load is applied, effort, and where is the load? Okay, car is the load, very good. And where is the effort?
And between and
yes.
Effort, he is putting it on the car jack, ma'am.
On the car jack, very good. Okay. So, well, here you can see a man holding the car jack, correct? By his hand. Therefore, effort would be in downward direction on the handle of the car jack. And you can understand that the load would be the car, as you have told me just now. So here I have clearly understood what is the, where is the effort is applied by a man and which is the load. So load is the car and the effort applied by a man on the handle in a downward direction. Okay, so this is clear to you all. Now, in this picture, you can see that whenever you go to grocery shop in supermarket, it is difficult to carry you stuff in the basket. You all know that. See here, this lady is carrying a basket along with her, but it's difficult for her. So she is holding it by both the hands. So it is very difficult to handle the basket. So we prefer using a trolley like this. We all know that we use a trolley whenever you go to the supermarket. Maybe you are going to DMart or Reliance, wherever. You can see this trolley has wheels. You can see here this trolley has wheels which are connected to this axle. Okay, it is four wheels. You can see here they are connected to the axle. So this trolley, which is having wheel, is also a simple machine, children. And it helps us to carry heavy objects like all our grocery items. By applying smaller efforts, by pushing a trolley, we can overcome the load. If you take this all groceries in a basket, it's very difficult for you to walk. But when you're using this simple machine, which are connected to the axle, this wheel. Okay, it helps us to move this load very easy. Correct? These two examples have understood. We'll move to the third one example, children. Now you can see, now while riding bicycle, do you apply the efforts on the wheel to move the bicycle, children? Yes? Can you tell me? Yes? Other, is it yes? I'm asking the question.
Yes, ma'am.
Listen carefully. While riding a bicycle, do you apply the efforts on the wheel to move the bicycle? You are applying the efforts on the wheel to move the bicycle?
Sneha.
Yes, very good. On what?
Paddle.
Yeah, on a paddle. Well, you can say no when I asked you the question, a boy is applying efforts on a wheel, it's wrong, it's no. But if you say a pedal, it is correct. You apply effort on the pedals of the bicycle, correct? By applying the smaller effort on pedal of the bicycle, it moves a larger wheels and you go a longer distance because you're applying effort on a pedal so that the bicycle is moving a longer distance, or you can say a larger distance. So in this case, the pedal and the wheel of the bicycle, the pedal and the wheel of the bicycle is also a simple machine. And this allows you to apply effort at a convenient point. This boy is applying an effort at a convenient point. He is not applying the effort somewhere back or on the wheels. He is applying on a convenient point, that is on a pedal. And also he is going in one direction, that means in a convenient direction, in order to move a larger distance or a long distance. Also the direction in a convenient direction and also on the convenient point. So these are the three examples to understand what is mechanical advantage. I have taken these three examples. So now, you know, there are many advantages of simple machine. But in terms of physics, the advantage of using machine can be described by its mechanical advantage. Okay. So for a simple machine, mechanical advantage defines three major aspects. There are three major aspects, and I have given those three major aspects on your screen. That is the first one, how much it multiplies the effort exerted in moving the load, that is called as what? Force multiplier. So first example I have taken here. This first example is the exact matching for the first point. How much it multiplies the effort exerted in moving the load. Okay. This is the first example for this. Now you can see here, this man is applying effort on the handle, the force multiplier, and the load is overcoming. So this is the first example which will exactly match for this first point. The second one is, now how much faster is the work done in moving the load by the machine? That it is called as what? Gain in speed. So in the second example, you have seen that because of this trolley, because of the wheel, you have gained the speed to move. When you are carrying the basket and you are moving, it is difficult to you to walk. But when you are using this trolley, you can gain a speed with the help. Anyhow, you have a load, but even though you can move faster, you can gain a speed because of this simple machine. So here, the second point will match for this example. Next, third one is, what is the change in direction or point of application of effort? So these are the three points. And for this third one, exactly this example will match, children. So it is asked here, what is the change in direction or point of application of effort? So this example, we have shown that this boy is applying an effort on a convenient point. Or you can say this boy is going in a particular direction, in a convenient direction. So these are the three major aspects of a simple machine, of a mechanical advantage. Okay, so these are the three major aspects. Next, mechanical advantage, that is MA, is equals to output force divided by input force. So the formula for the mechanical advantage. Now, mechanical advantage can be described by this given formula. I have told you here, that is output force divided by input force. Now, what is this input force, children? The input force is a force which you have given on the machine. That is effort. Okay. Input force is a force which you have given on the machine. That is effort. Clear? And output force is a force which is done on the load to overcome the load. Okay, output force is on the load and input force is on the effort. So output force is nothing but what? Load. And input force is nothing but what? Effort. Okay. So this expression can be written as load by effort. So it has the mechanical advantage, don't have any units. So it has no unit. Mechanical advantage don't have any unit. Okay. Next one. Now, you know that mechanical advantage is nothing but load by effort. So now there are different kinds of simple machines. We know that. In some, maybe load is greater than the effort. Yes. In some machines, maybe a load is smaller than the effort. Or in some machines, maybe load is equals to effort. So there are again three major aspects here. So you can see here, the mechanical advantage can be either greater than one, or either equal to one, or it is less than one. So you can see here, load is greater than effort. That time mechanical advantage is also greater than one. Okay. When the load is equal to effort, mechanical advantage is equals to one. Okay. And when the load is less than effort, mechanical advantage is less than one. Now, how to understand this thing? So let us understand this by seeing some examples which will define these preconditions. Okay, we'll take three examples to understand this in a better way. So you can see in the first example, children, here. Okay, see here, using nutcracker to break a nut, which is very difficult to do it by hand. Already we have discussed it this. When you take this nut and if you are cracking it, it's very difficult to do it by hand. But when you take it, this nutcracker, it's very simple to you to crack that nut. Correct? So what happens here? We are using a smaller effort and we are overcoming a very large load. So in this case, the load is what? Greater than the effort. Correct? So in this case, less effort is applied to overcome the greater load. So this one example to show that how the load is greater than the effort. Correct? So load is greater than effort. That time mechanical advantage is also greater than one. Or you can write mechanical advantage is equals to load divided by effort. Okay, because load is greater than effort. So this is the perfect example to show how the load is greater than the effort, children. Okay. So less effort is required to overcome a greater load. Now let us understand the second one, how the load is equals to effort. We have understood now how the load is greater than effort by taking an example of this nutcracker and nut. Okay. So here we have applied very less effort, but the which is greater load, we have overcome it. Okay. Now the second one is when the load is equals to effort. Now this example already you have seen in the previous class, children. We can see here this girl is trying to pull a water bucket. Okay. Now see here. Now imagine this condition where you can lift up a water bucket directly upward from a well. Or you can use simple pulley for lifting a water bucket by applying effort in a downward direction. Correct? The water bucket does not change. The water bucket will change. The shape of the water bucket will change. It will become smaller or it will become bigger. No, it will remain same. Correct? Therefore, the load remains same, children. And the effort also remains same. How? Because a girl is applying the effort in a downward direction. But here the direction is changing. The effort is equal and the load is also equal. But only the change is there, that is direction. Okay. Here the direction of effort is applied is changing in a downward direction. But the load and the effort is equal here. Therefore, we can say that load is equal to effort. And in such cases, mechanical advantage is also equal to 1. So you can say that the effort is applied in a convenient direction. When this girl is applying effort in a convenient direction, that means the load is equals to effort. This is the second example which will match this. Load is equals to effort. Now we have to see how the load is smaller than the effort. Now in this third picture, you can see here. Now consider this case. In this case, this hockey player is using a greater effort. He is using a greater effort in moving a small load. Here you can see it's a very small load. Maybe a small ball is here and he is trying to move that ball. But to move that ball, he is applying a greater effort and the load is very small. Okay. But he is using the larger distance. So in this case, effort is greater than the load, or you can say the load is smaller than the effort. In such case, mechanical advantage is also smaller than 1. So you can say that effort is exerted to obtain a greater movement of the load. Okay, so this is the three example to understand these three aspects of mechanical advantage. Next, for practical machines, the machine mechanical advantage is not always constant. Only for the practical machines, the mechanical advantage is not always constant. It depends on the load and other resistive force. Or example, friction. Okay. Now, this picture is there. Every time I have taken this picture, what you can see in this? What you can see in this? What you can see in this? This picture. Yeah. What is happening here? What you can imagine here? No answer? All are there? Okay. We have seen in previous slides that the pedals of the bicycle is a simple machine. Already many times I have discussed this. Pedal of the bicycle is a simple machine. But why? Because we apply a small effort on the pedal to move the wheels, which moves a very long distance. So pedals of bicycle in this case is a simple machine. Many times I have discussed this. This pedal of a bicycle is a simple machine. Now, if I ask you how much distance the machine moves, now if I ask you this question, how much distance the machine moves in doing the work, what will be the answer for this? Can you guess? How much distance the machine moves in doing the work? Can you guess what is the answer for this? Well, in terms of physics, this can be defined as a velocity ratio. If I'll ask you the question, how much distance the machine moves in doing the work, in the physics, this can be defined as velocity ratio. So what is velocity ratio? Velocity ratio is equals to velocity of effort divided by velocity of load. Or you can say that velocity ratio can be defined as how much effort moves in doing the work. How much effort moves in doing the work and how much the machine moves the load in doing the work is nothing but what? Velocity ratio. So this is the definition of what? Velocity ratio. Okay, so let us see in detail what exactly a velocity ratio is. Okay, so you can see here, velocity, we know that it is displacement by time. This velocity formula you already studied in the previous class. So velocity formula is what? Displacement divided by time, already you studied. So now here it is given that there is a new term here, dE and dl. What do you mean by this dE and dl here? So this d indicates that termed as displacement, and E is nothing but what? Effort. Okay, so displacement of effort can be termed as dE. Okay, so dE is the distance moved by the effort at time t, and the displacement for the load is can be termed as dl. So here d is again distance and l is again load. Okay, so dl is displacement for load. So dl is the distance moved by the load at time t. So clear about these two terms, what is dE and what is dl?
Any yes, ma'am.
Okay. So in this picture, you can see this example is given. You can see here, this man is giving an effort on this bar. Very clearly you can see when you see this picture, this man is applying an effort on this bar to lift up this load, to lift up this heavy stone, correct? And the distance moved by effort in this case would be the length of the bar, correct? The distance moved in this case is what? Length of the bar, that is dE. Okay, distance, displacement, effort. And the distance moved by the load in this case would be dl. Okay, this is the load dl. Now, velocity of effort can be written as, how can be written as now with the help of this example, this man is applying some effort to lift this load. So he has applied effort and this is the displacement. And for the load is moved from here to here. So that is dl. Okay, so now let us understand this velocity of effort. So velocity of effort can be written as dE by t. dE is nothing but what? Displacement for effort. T is time. Okay, dL is displacement of a load or for a load and time. Now, what will be the velocity ratio? Well, it will be velocity of effort by velocity of load. What will be the velocity of load? Velocity of effort divided by velocity of load. Now you can substitute the value. Okay, when we are substituting the value of velocity of effort, that is, we have taken here dE by t, displacement of effort divided by t, substitute the velocity of load. That is, it is somewhere, it has come up and down, no? Children, see this velocity of effort is only this. Excuse me. dE by t. Okay. Just do the changes there, some little changes there. Velocity of effort is nothing but what? Displacement of effort divided by t. Okay. It has come up and down, and velocity of load is equals to what? Displacement of a load divided by t. And velocity ratio is nothing but what? Velocity of effort divided by velocity of load. So clear? This is come up and down, okay? Velocity ratio, velocity of effort is this, velocity of load is this, and velocity ratio is this. Now just substitute the values. Velocity of effort, dE by t, we have substituted. Velocity of load, dL by t, we have substituted. When you cross multiply, what happens now here? When you take this, you can see here. When you take it up, you will multiply, this t will come up. Okay, t divided by dl. Correct? When you take it up, reciprocal it. Now what happens here? P and P get cancelled. These both get cancelled. What is remaining now? Displacement of effort divided by displacement of load. So what is the velocity ratio here now? dE by dL. So very clearly we got here the velocity ratio is dE upon dL. Okay. So velocity ratio is equals to displacement of effort divided by displacement of load. Again, both the time it is displacement and displacement. So the unit of displacement, both the time it get cancelled. So it has no unit. What is the unit of displacement, children? Can you tell me? What is the unit of displacement? You have studied in the previous class, no? What is the unit of displacement? Yes, quickly. What is the unit of displacement? Meter, correct. Very good. So, if we write here, if we write, see, as you said that displacement unit is meter, so m divided by displacement again meter, and both get cancelled. Nothing is remains. Yes, so it has no unit. So velocity ratio don't have any unit. Correct? Have you understood this concept? Any doubt in this, children? Any doubt? Can we go ahead? Okay, fine. Okay. So the next slide. So now we can see here velocity ratio, that is VR in short form we can say, displacement of effort divided by displacement of load, already we have discussed, that is dE upon dL. Okay. So here also there can be three conditions for VR, that is velocity ratio. When the displacement of effort can be greater than the displacement of load. So, in that case, velocity ratio is also greater than 1. You can see here, again, there are three conditions. How the mechanical advantage has three conditions, same way for velocity ratio also we have three conditions. The first condition is displacement of effort is greater than the displacement of a load. That time, velocity ratio is also greater than 1. Next, there might be time when displacement of effort is equals to displacement of load. In that case, velocity of ratio is equals to 1. And it might be so that displacement of effort is less than the displacement of load. So in that case, velocity ratio is also less than 1. So these are the three condition. So to understand three condition, we will take again few examples like how we had taken it for the mechanical advantage. So let us take few examples to understand these three conditions. The first one is, you can see here, see this example. I have taken the example of a plier. Who uses this plier, children? Can you tell me? Most probably who uses? Who uses this plier, children? Yeah. When we say who uses the books, suddenly it comes in our mind. Students, teachers, even other people take the books. But first point will come in our mind, teachers, students. Similar way, I'm asking here, when you see this example of plier, who's name or whose thing will come in your mind? I'm asking this question to you all. Who uses quickly? No answer. Who uses the plier? Very good, electrician. For what they use plier, children? Okay, electricians they use, but why? What is the use of this plier? Why they use this plier? This is a tool of electrician, no? An important tool. But why they use? Very good. To cut wire. Which wires, children? Which wires? Plastic wires. Very good. You are telling that to use the wire. Which wire? Copper wire. Very good. It's metal wire also we can say. Yes? The metal things, to cut the metal things, electrician use this plier. Okay, see this example of plier which used to cut wires in metal items. Correct. In this case, the effort applied on both the handles moves a longer distance. And when we apply effort, the load will move a very small distance. You can see, children, to cut any metal wire, or if an electrician using this plier to cut a copper wire, what he does? He applies an effort on this both the handles to order to overcome this load. So what he does when he applies, you can see that both the load will come. What it happens? You can see here. Okay, so the displacement of effort in this case is greater. You can see the displacement is more here. The distance between these two handles is more. Okay, but here the displacement is very small. You can see here. The displacement is very small. So the displacement of effort in this case is greater than the displacement of a load. Correct? Therefore, in such case, VR, that is velocity ratio, is greater than 1. Okay. So in this type of machine, VR is greater than 1. Is known as what? Force multiplier. Such machines are called as what? Force multiplier. But why force multiplier? Why these machines are called as a force multiplier? Because the effort you are applying is lesser than the load which is being overcome. Though the effort moving a longer distance, but the effort have a force lesser than the load. So these types of machines are known as force multiplier. The displacement might be more, okay, but the force applied is very less. So VR is greater than 1. Yes, VR is greater than 1, not smaller than 1. VR is, velocity ratio is what? Greater than 1. So what are the force multiplier? It is, force multiplier is nothing but when the effort moves a greater distance than the load, such type of machines are called as what? Force multiplier machines. In this case, effort moves a greater distance than the load, but the force applied is very small. So clear about this example? Clear? Any doubt in this example? Next example, you can see here. When you see this picture, what you feel? What you imagine when you see this picture? Have you played this game, children? Have you played this game? Maybe everyone has played this game, is it? When you are small, maybe everyone went to go to park with your parents, with your friends. You always like to play such type of games. Correct? And everybody likes to play. Now only when you become elder, no, you just leave all the games and you are all busy in WhatsApp, Facebook, Messenger, many things. And these playing games, you are just leaving it. It's very so sad. Instead of playing outside in a park, nowadays children are playing on the mobile. I can understand due to COVID now you are not going out. But there are many activities you can do it at home also. You can play carrom, you can play Again, what you can play at home? Carom you can play, chess you can play. So many things are there at home also. If you have a small garden in front of your house, you can play the rings. Many things are there. You can play, and due to that, you can have exercise, you can keep your body healthy, but nowadays children are not at all interested in that. Okay. So here also there is one good example for you all. We can see here seesaw. Okay, can you see which is load and which is effort here? When you see, you can feel that load and effort might be equal. Also, the distance moved by the effort is equal to distance moved by a load, because you can see here this is the balance. Okay, so you can feel the distance is a distance moved by load and distance moved by effort will be equal. You will think that. Now you can see here effort that is applied, the distance moved in a downward direction, and the load also here distance moved in a upward direction. So in both the case you can say the distance moved by the effort and the load is same. The distance is same here, so that you can say displacement of effort is equals to displacement of a load. In such case you can say velocity ratio is equals to 1. In such case what we can say, velocity of ratio is equals to 1. Okay, next example. You can see here in this picture on your slide, I have taken the example of scissor. This is a simple machine again. Children, can you tell me now where do we apply effort in the scissor? Where do we apply effort in the scissor? Where we are applying effort in the scissor? Already I have given the answer, but even though I want from your side, on a handle. Very good, Vishal. Very good, Sneha. We are applying effort on a handle of a scissor. Correct. Okay, on the handle of the scissor, and by applying effort, the load doing longer distance. Correct. If moves a longer distance, that is pedal of a scissor. Sorry, not pedal, blade. Pedal is for a bicycle. Sorry, a blade. That is blade of a scissor. Move far from each other. You can say when we are applying efforts, the load, that is a blade of the scissor, are moving far from each other in forward direction in cutting a paper or a cloth. Correct. So in this case, what happens? DE is smaller than DL, because when you are applying force, you can see that this handle is comes towards each other and the blades moves far. Okay, so here effort is smaller than the load, therefore you can say VR, that is velocity ratio, is smaller than 1. And such type of machines are called as distance multiplier. The scissor is a distance multiplier machine. So why we can call a distance multiplier? Because the load moves a greater distance than the effort. See here, when we apply effort, the handles are coming towards each other, the distance is decreasing, whereas the blades are not coming towards each other, they are moving far away. So the load moves a greater distance than the effort. So these are the three examples to understand these three conditions of velocity ratio. Now you can see here, the velocity ratio of a machine of a particular design is always constant. As in the previous class, I had told you that we know that mechanical advantage is not constant for practical machine. I think in this class only, even velocity ratio of a machine of a particular design is always constant. is not same, it's always constant. Okay, it is always constant. So this is about the mechanical advantage and the velocity ratio. Any doubt in this, children?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So tomorrow I will start with the relationship between mechanical advantage and what is there? Velocity ratio. Okay. So till here, any doubt? Till here, any doubt? You have any doubt here?